4321 Section 205 of the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973 confers a discretion on the court to exempt an accused from personal appearance till such time his appearance is considered by the court to be not necessary during the trial. It is manifest from a plain reading of the provision that while considering an application under section 205 of the code, the magistrate has to bear in mind the nature of the case as also the conduct of the personal summoned. He shall examine whether any useful purpose would be served by requiring the personal attendance of the accused or whether the progress of the trial is likely to be hampered on account of his absence. Therefore, the satisfaction whether or not an accused deserves to be exempted from personal attendance has to be of the magistrate, who is the master of the court in so far as the progress of the trial is concerned and none else. The guidelines laid down by this court in Bhaskar Industries Limited are concurred with, and while reaffirming the same, this court would add that the order of the magistrate should be such which does not result in unnecessary harassment to the accused and at the same time does not cause any prejudice to the complainant. The court must ensure that the exemption from personal appearance granted to an accused is not abused to delay the trial. In view of the legal principles enunciated by the court, the impugned order is clearly erroneous, is as much as the discretion of the magistrate under section 205 of the code cannot be circumscribed by laying down any general directions in that behalf. Similarly, while it is true that the power of superintendence conferred on the High Court under Article 227 of the Constitution of India is both administrative and judicial, but such power is to be exercised sparingly and only in appropriate cases in order to keep the subordinate courts within the bounds of their authority. In any event, the power of superintendence cannot be exercised to influence the subordinate judiciary to pass any order or judgment in a particular manner. As regards direction in the order of the single judge of the High Court to accept and consider the written statement made by the accused, it is again not in accord with the language of S313 of the code nor with the dictum laid down by this court in Basavaraj R. Patil's case. On the plain language of S313, it is evident that in a summons case, when the personal appearance of the accused has been dispensed with under section 205 of the code, a discretion is vested in the magistrate to dispense with the rigor of personal examination of the accused under section 313 of the code as well. It is manifest from the judgment in Basavaraj R. Patil's case that dispensation with the personal examination of an accused in terms of the provision of S313(1)(h) is within the trial court's discretion to be exercised, keeping in view certain parameters enumerated therein and not as a matter of course. It is true that in discretion in the impugned judgment, the single judge has clarified that the stipulations in the proceeding paragraphs are not intended to fetter the discretion of the court to follow any different procedure if there be compelling need, but the requirement of recording specific reasons by the magistrate for deviating from the directions given in the order as stipulated in the same paragraph is by itself tantamount to putting fetters on the jurisdiction of the magistrate. This is not warranted in law. Thus, in the instant case, the High Court exceeded its jurisdiction under section 482 of the Code and or article 227 of the Constitution by laying down the general directions which are inconsistent with the clear language of sections 205 and 313 of the Code. In light of the guidelines laid down by this court, further directions on the same issue by the High Court were wholly uncalled for. The impugned order containing general directions to the lower courts is set aside. However, if the accused moves the trial court with an application under section 205 of the Code for exemption from personal attendance within the time stated, the exemption granted to her by the High Court shall continue to be in force till her application is disposed of by the trial court. Challenge in this appeal by special leave is to the order dated 4 September 2008 passed by a learned single judge of the High Court of Kerala in 2007.